Looking to build your business connections today? Look no further than BEI Connect's video conferencing app feature to schedule professional meetings at your fingertips. Just select your preferred date and time and enjoy the abundant business connections we offer on our platform. Not only do we offer video conferencing, but our unique interactive messaging and chatting service allows you to keep connected on a massively unrestricted global scale. Looking to get more organized today? Schedule your own personalized appointments through our inbuilt scheduling feature. BEI Connect as an application promises global client connections with respective vendors, finance, economic, insurance, and stock brokers, property purchasers, reputable academics, and other prolific individuals in industry. Build your business through an international marketing medium. With BEI Connect, you can pitch your business ideas and showcase them through our unique project feature that enables international retention and an opportunity for all BEI Connect users to expand their business using our interactive platform. Sign up with BEI Connect and connect directly with your global business partners. With only one click away, install the app on the Google and Apple Store.
Conscious consumer, your decisions at the seafood counter have never been more complex. You want to make the best choice for your family, your local community, and the environment. And now there's a choice that meets all of these needs, a sustainable, local way to farm healthy fish, no matter where you are. Today, fish are being farmed on land, in tanks where clean water is continuously filtered and recycled, and waste can be used as fertilizer for our farmers. It's called Recirculating Aquaculture Systems, or RAS. Since RAS fish are grown in a controlled and traceable environment without the use of antibiotics or hormones, they deliver all of seafood's health benefits safely and sustainably. RAS technology can be used anywhere, so its fish can always be locally grown, helping local economies and providing a fresher product. Given that 90% of U.S. seafood is currently imported, and that twice the current supply will be needed by 2050, there's a growing need for new ways to produce high-quality, local fish without putting more pressure on our oceans. RAS has a minimal impact on the environment, leaving half the carbon footprint of imports. It's water efficient, recycles nutrients and byproducts, and conserves wild fish. Plus, RAS fish are fed sustainable feeds that don't require wild-caught fish to be used in their food for a zero fish-in, fish-out ratio. The Conservation Fund is focused on developing solutions in areas like RAS and many others that ensure a healthy planet for future generations.
If we're going to actually protect our oceans, we have to make that transition from hunting-gathering to farming. It's what we've done with all of our other food production.
To walk into a restaurant and order a steak of a wild cow, that doesn't exist anymore.
The reality is we are farming just about everything else that we're consuming, so why not fish?
We're already farming more than half the global seafood production. We're farming more seafood than we are beef globally, and it's only going to continue.
Thank you. aquaponics is a method of food production that combines raising fish and vegetables in a soilless, sustainable system. We raise fish in tanks and we feed those fish a quality diet. The fish waste leaves the fish tanks and goes into a series of filter tanks where it breaks down naturally through a biological process. The result is nutrients that we need for plant growth. The plants are grown in separate tanks where they pull out those nutrients, helping to clean the water for the fish. The water circulates through the system 24 hours a day, resulting in continuous production of both fish and vegetables. There are many applications of aquaponic food production. Homeowners use aquaponics to grow fresh fish and vegetables for their family, knowing that it's clean and pure food. Entrepreneurs use aquaponics to grow food in a for-profit venture, providing fresh food, fresh fish and vegetables to people in their community. Schools and universities embrace this technology so that they can teach aquaponics as well as all different facets of science, nutrition, agriculture, and much more. Food banks and missions use aquaponics to provide fresh, nutritious food to people in need. There are many benefits of aquaponic food production. Most importantly, our fertilizer is derived from the fish waste in a natural manner. We don't rely on mined and manufactured fertilizers, and we use substantially less water than traditional agriculture. Another very unique difference is that our systems do not use soil. When we eliminate soil-borne disease and the pests that dwell in the soil. Essentially, this reduces our risk in growing food. We don't use pesticides, herbicides, or chemical fertilizers, and we grow in an environment that prevents contamination. We grow significantly more food per acre than traditional agriculture. When we combine aquaponics with a controlled environment, we can produce food continuously year-round in any climate.
What are the best fish for aquaponics? First, you will need to consider these factors. Environmental conditions. Your location, is it hot, cold, or tropical? Choose a fish that suits these conditions. If you are in a cold location, perhaps you will need heating. Feed sources. What food do you have access to for feeding your fish? Will you grow duckweed? Will you breed black soldier fly larvae? Purpose. Are you wanting fish to eat or just for producing waste to feed your plants? Size. How big will your fish tank be and how many fish will you stock? Is it a small desktop system or a big system? That would be great for delicious Murray cod. Is it legal? The fish you want could be classified as an invasive species, so remember to check with your local fishery department. First, let's look at edible fish for aquaponics. Tilapia. Cichlid fall under the tilapia species of fish and are a hardy fish found in freshwater shallow streams, ponds, and rivers. Cichlids are a nutritious fish that is high in protein. Tilapia species of fish can survive in a temperature of around 11 to 17 degrees Celsius, 52 to 62 degrees Fahrenheit. In the wild, cichlids are mostly omnivores. However, you can feed your cichlids live or frozen animal food, such as shrimp and bloodworms. An easy source of food would be sinking pellets or flake fish food, which are rich in protein and fiber. You can, occasionally, feed your tilapia-type fish green foods like spinach. Catfish. Catfish are also suitable for aquaponics. Their colours and shapes vary and can be very pretty as an ornamental fish. They are particularly great at cleaning the tank walls and substrate. They will, in turn, keep the algae under control and will recycle food and waste from other fish. Catfish are also hardy fish and are not prone to disease or illness, but can get stressed if threatened by larger fish, so just be aware of who you put in the tank with them. As they are bottom feeders or benthic, catfish will need to be fed food that sinks, like sinking pellets or a heavier type of frozen fish food. In addition, they like to feed at night once the aquarium lights are out, so remember that for your feeding schedule. As for preferred water temperature, anywhere between 20 and 24 degrees Celsius, 68 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit is good. A few varieties to consider are zebra pleco, cory, bristlenosed catfish, and clown catfish. Next, silver perch. As silver perch can grow to a relatively large size of around 8 kilograms or 600 millimeters in length, you will need to consider the size of your tank. The preferred temperature for silver perch outside of spawning season is between 18 to 23 degrees Celsius, 73 to 82 degrees Fahrenheit. As far as eating goes, they love green plants, so some spinach, duckweed, or azolla will do nicely. Jade perch. While similar looking to the silver perch in shape, it has a greenish hue to its upper region, hence their name. They prefer warmer water, although cooler than their cousins, the silver perch. Favorable temperatures would be about 20 to 28 degrees Celsius, 68 to 82 degrees Fahrenheit. They too like an omnivorous diet and can be seen eating any green variety of plant or fish food low in animal protein. Murray cod. Murray codfish are reasonably new to the aquaponics lifestyle and in fact new to tank culture. They need space and are a quick growing fish, so take that into account when setting up your aquarium. They need to be fed often or they may just start eating each other. They are a carnivorous fish, obviously, so be aware not to put them in a tank with smaller fish. Even if the species is Murray cod, they will eat them. A diet rich in protein and phosphorus is good, so be sure to check your fish food labels. Ideal temperature, as they are originally a river fish, would be around 8 to 24 degrees Celsius, 46 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit, so they can handle quite a cold tank. On a side note, they're a really popular fish to catch from the rivers in my hometown and are absolutely delicious. Barramundi. These fish are very popular in aquaponic systems and are often grown in the warmer months and with slightly mature stock. If you intend to eat your barramundi, you will find they have a lovely, clean, crisp taste. As a tank fish, they will still love to eat fish and crustaceans, so a diet rich in frozen fish, shrimp or prawns will go down very nicely. They do well in warmer temperatures, so make sure the water is around 26 to 30 degrees Celsius, 78 to 86 degrees Fahrenheit. Trout. Besides being a great tasting fish, trout have a very quick growth rate as well as food conversion ratio, meaning they convert their digested food to fertilizer very fast. They prefer a cooler temperature between 10 to 20 degrees Celsius, 52 to 62 degrees Fahrenheit, and originally a river fish. They like to eat aquatic and terrestrial insects as well as other fish, leeches, crustaceans, and worms. For commercial food, you could try frozen bloodworm and dried shrimp. Bluegill. Bluegills are probably one of the most unfussy fish. They will eat pretty much anything, but that doesn't mean you must feed them just anything. Stick to a diet of insects, zooplankton, small fish, and worms. Frozen bloodworms are good as well as any flank or pellet type of fish food. In terms of a preferable temperature for the tanks, water can range anywhere between 16 to 27 degrees Celsius, 60 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit. If you are not wanting to eat your fish, check out these ornamentals that are great for aquaponics. Ornamental aquaponics fish. Goldfish. Your hardiest and by far most popular pet fishes, but also a great option for aquaponics. They have longevity and come in a variety of breeds and colors. Goldfish will survive just nicely on flake fish food and prefer a temperature of around 10 to 23 degrees Celsius, 50 to 74 degrees Fahrenheit. If you intend to breed them, you will need to consider some plant cover. They are shy like that. Koi, our beautiful bevy of fish species, and are in fact from the carp family of fish, predominantly found in Asian communities, these picturesque fish are best grown in larger ornamental type tanks or aquariums. Due to their lovely variety of colors, you want to ensure the food you feed them is high in beta carotene, which will enhance and help keep their natural colors. Huge omnivores, you can feed your fish lettuce, watermelon, and peas, but it is best to rather do this using specific koi fish food, as this has been accurately measured out for the best nutritional balance. Happy in a slightly warmer environment, you can ensure water temperature is between 15 to 25 degrees Celsius, 59 to 77 degrees Fahrenheit. Siamese fighting fish, better. These fish are just stunning. With their goldfish-style bodies but flowing fins and tails, they are just beauties to watch. They have a very particular diet as well, in that they like live brine shrimp and bloodworm, although frozen will do too. In addition, you can make their main source of food, for sake of ease, Siamese fighting fish granules or pellets. They should be fed 1 to 2 times daily and in small quantities, as they have a tendency to overeat. Being a tropical fish, you need to keep the water temperature at a warm 25 to 26 degrees Celsius, 78 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Warning: as they are fighting fish, you cannot put more than one betta or fighting fish in the tank at a time. They will fight each other to the death. Suggestion is to either go with a sorority of female bettas, but no less than 4. Ensure your tank size is ideal. Other ornamental fish worth having a look at are guppies and white cloud mountain minnows. Practically any freshwater fish you can find at your aquarium store will be suited for aquaponics.
simulator. It tracks every detail of your club and ball through impact to give you the most realistic ball flight simulation available anywhere in the world.
HD Golf combines innovative high-definition camera and vision technology with 21st century mapping techniques. This isn't a video game, it's a game of golf. Four cameras developed by HD Golf capture and analyze every aspect of a swing within milliseconds. From the arc of the club to point of contact with the ball. This high-tech setup seamlessly integrates all data through its professional golf instruction studio.
There's four separate cameras in our system. One is dedicated specifically to tracking the club head as it comes through impact and measures the club face within a tenth of a degree. Second camera is responsible for tracking the spin of the ball. And not just the spin within 25 RPMs, but the axis on which it's spinning, which is what gives the ball flight such its such unique signature. The other two cameras, the final two in the basic system, are arranged stereoscopically, which means the field of vision overlaps, and they capture the horizontal and vertical launch angles and the speed of the ball.
A touchscreen interface and cutting-edge software created in-house tee off for a round of golf like no other. Video capture and playback options break new ground for instant feedback. Users can measure and study the complete golfing experience, comparing it to that of a pro golfer. Swing analysis and dynamics analysis is among the tools that will take anyone's game to the next level. Analyze your chip shots and slices, and make adjustments to take strokes off your game. High-definition golf is as challenging and exciting as a real golf experience. The secret sauce is in the development of the technology.
So how we build the courses is we take satellite data of the golf course, and then we go to the ground level and take laser scan geophysical data and combine them to build a perfect 3D rendering of the golf course. Then, the really exciting part is we overlay actual high resolution digital images from every single point in the golf course. So what you get is a golf course that not only plays real from everywhere along the course, but looks real as well. So it looks and plays exactly like the real thing.
The simulator's spectacular photorealistic capabilities capture the true essence of some of the world's most renowned courses. Pebble Beach, Pinehurst, Kiawah Island, Spyglass, Bethpage, and many others. A team of software and hardware engineers leave nothing to chance. Every bunker, curve, slope, and nuances of every course is crucial to the high-definition golf experience. HD is more than just a simulator. It's a true golf game, with innovative mapping technology that reproduces the world's most challenging courses to a unique four-camera design that captures every aspect of a swing. HD Golf provides the tools to improve anyone's technique without sacrificing the thrill of the game. The hole-in-one might not be a dream any longer.
Gold Coast is situated in subtropical Queensland, just an hour's drive from the state capital, Brisbane. It's a fast-growing city of 500,000 people, drawn by the miles of perfect coastline and a sun-drenched lifestyle. The central Gold Coast skyline looks like a gathering of giants wriggling their toes in the warm Pacific. There's a natural spirit here, bound in the incredible beaches, the ocean's shifting moods, and the cool waterfalls and deep forests of the hinterland. But there's a human spirit too, dedicated to family, vitality, and having the time of your life. The Gold Coast got its start as a vacation retreat in the 1850s, near its northern end. It's here that the Gold Coast still shines brightest. Surfer's Paradise is a complete destination in itself, a glittering resort, shopping, and entertainment strip.
Of living in Surfer's Paradise every weekend. We're out on the beach, walking, surfing. You get to know all the fantastic local restaurants and coffee shops, riding your bikes everywhere, you know, just really making the most of the community that is Surfer's Paradise. Surfer's Paradise to me means fun and freedom. I think it's a place that keeps you young. It has that wow factor every single day because you can't ignore it and you just feel alive. It gives you energy. Obviously, like other mums, I love to shop. Surfer's Paradise is so close to everything. So you've got a lot of vintage boutiques that are starting to take place here on the Gold Coast. So you can get some really alternative clothes. And then you've got the fantastic shopping centres, which, you know, offer something for everyone. The great part about all this is you can walk to a lot of these places. And with the light rail now, you can jump on at Surfer's Paradise and be Pacific Fair in 1 minute. There's so much to do here and there's so many attractions and there's so much for the kids too. Just the mere fact of enjoying it and being here is an attraction of itself. So when people get here, they do see the most beautiful beaches in the world and the beautiful buildings and this stunning natural environment, and there's so many fun things to do. And it just makes you feel great and young and not take life so seriously.
We are thrilled to present a land for sale. B-side DA approval for 120 apartments, 112 times 2 bedroom units, plus 6 sub penthouses, 2 penthouses and retail. Continued growth and development along the most sought after iconic Gold Coast beaches, world-class dining, entertainment and tourist attractions has put sites like this in short supply. This is a rare opportunity for astute developers who want to profit in Australia's premier tourist destination. This exciting opportunity comes with groundwork already completed. The beauty behind the architecture's magnificent vision was inspired by the marvelous backdrop that is Surfer's Paradise. DA approves for the following. The prime development site is in the heart of Surfer's Paradise, with 39-storey residential development and ground floor retail. The total land area amasses to 849 square metres, with a building height of 1,118.5 metres, a gross floor area of 20,268 square metres. The total number of units amassed to 120, with 112 two-bedroom units, 6 three-bedroom units, and 2 penthouses. Typical two-bedroom floor area, including balcony, which amasses to 90.5 square meters. It is only 50 meters from Surfer's Paradise Beach. A few key attributes include its prime location, the land area being 850 meters squared, the building height being 118.45 with unlimited height allowance. The gross floor area is 20,268 meters squared. Typical two floor bedroom area, including the balcony, is 90.5 meters squared with a corner block with large frontages. The light rail urban renewal area code with no building height limit. Live the Gold Coast lifestyle.
1.3 kilometres from Cavill Avenue's precinct, only 3.9 kilometres to SeaWorld Resort and Water Park. It's 3.9 kilometres to Broadwater Parklands and 5.3 kilometres from the Pacific Fair Shopping Precinct. It's 4.8 kilometres from Star Casino and 4.2 kilometres from the Gold Coast Convention and Exhibition Centre. It's 7.9 kilometres from the Gold Coast University and the University Hospital, and only 12 kilometres from Bond University, 39 kilometres for Coolangatta Domestic and International Airport. So contact us now for all the information on this not-to-be-missed opportunity.
Gold Coast is situated in subtropical Queensland, just an hour's drive from the state capital, Brisbane. It's a fast-growing city of 500,000 people, drawn by the miles of perfect coastline and a sun-drenched lifestyle. The central Gold Coast skyline looks like a gathering of giants wriggling their toes in the warm Pacific.
We are thrilled to present a land for sale, B-side DA approval for 120 apartments, 112 times 2 bedroom units, plus 6 sub penthouses, 2 penthouses and retail. Continued growth and development along the most sought after iconic Gold Coast beaches, world-class dining, entertainment and tourist attractions has put sites like this in short supply. This is a rare opportunity for astute developers who want to profit in Australia's premier tourist destination. This exciting opportunity comes with groundwork already completed. The beauty behind the architecture's magnificent vision was inspired by the marvelous backdrop that is Surfers Paradise. DA approves for the following. The prime development site is in the heart of Surfers Paradise, with 39-storey residential development and ground floor retail. The total land area amasses to 849 square metres, with a building height of 1,118.5 metres, a gross floor area of 20,268 square metres. The total number of units amass to 120, with 112 two-bedroom units, 6 three-bedroom units and 2 penthouses. Typical two-bedroom floor area, including balcony, which amasses to 90.5 square metres. It is only 50 metres from Surfers Paradise Beach. A few key attributes include its prime location, the land area being 850 metres squared, the building height being 118.45 with unlimited height allowance. The gross floor area is 20,268 meters squared. Typical two floor bedroom area, including the balcony, is 90.5 meters squared with a corner block with large frontages. The light rail urban renewal area code with no building height limit. Live the Gold Coast lifestyle, 1.3 kilometers from Cavill Avenue's precinct. only 3.9 kilometers to SeaWorld Resort and Water Park. It's 3.9 kilometers to Broadwater Parklands and 5.3 kilometers from the Pacific Fair Shopping Precinct. It's 4.8 kilometers from Star Casino and 4.2 kilometers from the Gold Coast Convention and Exhibition Center. It's 7.9 kilometers from the Gold Coast University and the University Hospital, and only 12 kilometers from Bond University, 39 kilometers from Coolangatta Domestic and International Airport. So contact us now for all the information on this not-to-be-missed opportunity.